friends, welcome to my March wrap-up part 1. This video will consist of two parts. First of all, I will talk about the 7 works that I finished in the first half of March, and then talk about the progression of my Bernas Bookish Bingo, which consists of a bingo card that I'm using for the first 3 months of 2021. First book that I finished in March was a carryover from February. The Silence of the Girls by Pat Barker. This is a retelling of the Troy War from the perspective of a slave girl who has been previously a queen in one of the island countries that Greek has invaded in those wars. But the title of the book is really appropriate, I think, because it talks about the treatment of women in those times, which was brutal. Even if they were royals or queen, they still were treated unjustly, but the other women were treated like they were the objects and property of other men. Especially the effects of war on a woman who lost their husbands, children, father in wars. There were some scenes which were too brutal for readers who do not like such scenes. Starting from this wrap-up, I will put the content warnings of the books in the description box below. It was also very interesting to know a different side of Achilles, who has been treated as a hero in the Odyssey. In the Odysseus, from point of view of his mistress, I found the writing style to be very dry. I gave this book an 8 out of 10. The second book that I finished was a bud read with Rainey from Rainey Day Reads. We are bud reading the Canadian West series together. We finished the third book this month, When Breaks the Dawn by Janette Oak. This book talks about the second year of their Wynne and Elizabeth marriage in the Northern Canadian West. And there are two main themes to the story. One of them is Elizabeth's decision to become a teacher again, but this time to the natives, the indigenous children, and how different it was for other kids who were kids of white race. And the second and the most important theme of the book was Elizabeth's desire to become a mother and her struggles of fertility. I found this book to have the most depth among the other two books that we read. I immensely enjoyed the first one because it was so heartwarming and so full of hope. But this one had something different, which was the characterization of Elizabeth being a very real person with jealousies and regrets and self-doubts and every other humanly feeling that a woman with no children can understand. Of course, there were some very sweet and heartwarming scenes as well. So I gave this book an 8 out of 10 as well. The next book was a book that I read for middle grade March for the prompt of a silhouette on the cover. I read this book originally written in Portuguese, in Turkish. The title of my book was Şeker Portakalı. The English title is My Sweet Orange Tree. And the author is José Mauro de Vasconcelos. I'm not sure if I'm pronouncing the name of the author correctly. In this book, we hear the story of a very clever 5-year boy who's very poor, and the struggles and the hardships that this 5-year-old faces, both within the family and outside of the family circle. This book was actually the favorite book of many of my friends in elementary school. And I had not read that book because I was interested in other more hopeful books. And when I read it this time, I'm really glad that I didn't read it at that time, because although the time period was defined very well in the book, there were two things that really annoyed me. One of them was the agitation factor. I mean, a middle grade book can have hard topics, but I felt like I was being forced to feel sorry for this little boy, and so many bad things happened to this little boy. And I was like, oh no, not again. So I felt like they were playing with my emotions, and the idea that this book could affect children much more made me feel horrified. And the other thing that I really didn't like was, although it was mentioned that the boy was much more clever than an average 5-year-old child, I found his actions to be unbelievable. He acted like he was 10 or 12. A child have an exceptionally high IQ, but the acts that this boy did in this book could have been only described by life experiences. A 5-year-old child cannot have such life lessons in only 5 years. It's impossible. So that's why I gave my sweet orange tree a 6 out of 10. The fourth work that I finished was fortunately much better. I read this short story for March Mystery Madness, in which I'm doing a special project of reading short stories that belong to classic, vintage or golden age mystery authors. I read The Mystery of Room 666 by Jacques Futrelle. It was a medium length short story. I think I fell in love with Jacques Futrelle's writing style. I immensely enjoyed the mystery, as well as the characters. And the first person point of view was handled so well. I was really impressed by this author, and I decided to research about this author, and I found out that he was killed in a Titanic accident. There is a story about how he gave the last place on the lifeboat to his wife. I was really sad to hear that he died in such a young age, because he could have been even more popular if he had written in his later years as well. I read the fifth book that I finished for middle grade March, but it can also be counted as a bonus book for March Mystery Madness as well, because it was a middle grade mystery, The Mysterious Mannequin by Carolyn Keene. This Nancy Drew story partly takes place in Turkey, and that's why I did a Turkish shelf video about this book, and I will link it down below, in which I talked much more about the book. But in summary, I can say that I really enjoyed the book because I didn't take the book very seriously. It even had an inner joke of trouble following Nancy when he encountered the cups for 3 times in a day. Overall, I gave this very enjoyable book a 7 out of 10. Oh, I forgot to say that I read this book for the prompt of journal for middle grade March. The sixth book that I finished was also another middle grade March book, The Red Shoe by Ursula Dubosarsky. This book takes place in 1954 Australia. It talks about three sisters' experiences following the World War II and its effects on the family, especially the father who went to war and fought. The story is told from point of view of the little sister most of the time, but the elder and the middle sister also tells the story in some chapters. I read this for the prompt of family. I found the storytelling to be very good. Because there were very distinct differences between the points of view of the sisters about the same event, which is a secondary subplot of a mystery surrounding the family. But I found the ending not satisfactory at all, so that's why I gave this middle grade book a 7 out of 10. And lastly, I finished The First 15 Lives of Harry August. I buddy read this book with Tia and Mary Ellen. This book is really hard to define, but I will try to explain it as much as I can without giving spoilers. Harry August goes through his life again and again, being reborn with the memories of his previous life, and that really affects how he views the world every time he is born again. During his 15 lives, he encounters a situation in which the world is threatened and tries to save the world by using very different and unconventional methods. First of all, the body reading experience was really good. I enjoyed both of my body reading partners' points of view about the book. And then I have to say I was fascinated by the plot. The methods that they used to prevent this disaster was very, very clever, and the characters were also incredibly clever because they had the knowledge of many, many lives. Additionally, I loved the philosophical, ethical, theological, and even existential questions this book asks all through the book, which made me think about them. And I love the depiction of social and political events without having a politically biased agenda. But what made this book not perfect, but 9 out of 10, was the fact that, especially in the first half of the book, the jumps between different lives of Harry was confusing. Also, I have to say, maybe the plot demanded it, but the characters were not really likable or relatable. That's why it got a 9 out of 10. But it was a book that really made me think about a lot of things and made me exercise my brain. It was the favorite book of the first half of the month. For Berna's Bookish Bingo, I made a blackout. I only had 4 prompts left when I did my February wrap-up part 2, and I was in the middle of one of the books, and I finished those 4 books for the remaining 4 prompts. For the prompt of Time of the Day in the title, I read When Breaks the Dawn by Janette Oak. For a new book, I read The Silence of the Girls by Pat Barker. The publication date was 2018. And when I did my prompts, I said that a new book should be newer than 2015, because I'm a backlist reader and books newer than 2015 are actually new books for me. For the prompt of an author from South America, I read My Sweet Orange Tree by José Mauro de Vasconcelos. The author is Brazilian, so he's from South America. And for the prompt of an author from Oceania, I read The Red Shoe by Ursula Dubosarsky, who's an Australian author. I managed to do a blackout in 2.5 months. I plan to do a separate video about the wrap-up of my first Bookish Bingo card. This was my March wrap-up, part 1. Please comment down below. Have you read any of the books that I mentioned in this video? Also, how are your readathons going? Because there are many, many readathons going on in March. If you're a new viewer, first of all, welcome. Please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! 'S for Turkish Word of the Day, since my favorite book of first half of March was the first 15 lives of Harry August, I thought first should be the word of the day. First means ilk in Turkish, and ilk is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day.